Are messy people more creative? Are organized people boring? As somebody who cannot find his keys underneath his dirty laundry, I say yes to both. And so does science. Anthony here for DNews, and there is this prevailing myth that messy people are super creative geniuses. Just look at the desks and workspaces of Albert Einstein, Roald Dahl, or Peter Parker, who is not real, but feels real in my heart. I like this theory because I'm a little disorganized myself, but is it true? And what traits come along with an organized life? Researchers at the University of Minnesota wanted to find out just that, and so they ran three studies to see how the tidiness of a room affects human behavior. In the first, people were sent into either a tidy room or a messy room and asked to think of all the creative ways to sell ping pong balls they could. People in each room gave the same amount of answers, but the two independent judges found the answers from the messy room more creative. And a previous study by Northwestern University showed that people in a messy room drew more creative pictures and could solve brain teasers faster. In the second Missouri study, the people in each room were given menus from a smoothie shop, and they were offered a smoothie with a free boost. In the tidy room, people were more likely to choose a boost that was labeled classic, while the people in the messy room were more likely to pick one labeled new. So the messy room led people to be drawn more towards novelty, while the tidy room was drawn more towards convention. Boring. Trailblazers, I tell ya. Messy trailblazers. Anyway, the final group was asked to fill out a questionnaire, and then they were offered either a chocolate bar or an apple. And here's the thing, the people in the messy room almost always went for chocolate, and tidy roomers went for the apple. I'm willing to admit to a certain level of impulsiveness, that's fine. And also those people were asked if they'd like to donate to a charitable organization, and the people in the clean room donated a lot more money, and they donated more often. Okay, so maybe tidy people make healthier, more ethical people, but the messy people are still the creative risk takers, and that counts for something, right? In reality, the results just seem to show that cleaner environments promote safe and conventional behavior, and messy ones cause a break from traditional thinking. Those things are not good or bad by definition. It just depends on what situation you're in. You know, speaking of somebody from the messy camp, though, it's important to remember that in a public space, like school or work, you do have to deal with other people's perceptions of your habits. 57% of people in a recent survey said they judge people by how clean they keep their workspaces, and nearly half of them said that a messy desk is a clear sign that the person who sits at it is straight up lazy. Maybe I should keep my desk clean, but secretly do all my work in the storage closet. Best of both worlds. Do you work better in a clean or a messy environment? I cannot think unless I am surrounded by clutter. Let me know down in the comments and subscribe for more D News.